power starting.
Oh shit.
Quiet on the set. Quiet on the set.
My name is Chris Alvarez. I'm a part of the Art of Illusions Car Club out of Hagerstown, Maryland. It's a 1972 Chevy C-10. Truck's gone under extensive suspension work. Done a full air ride suspension. Wanted to do a traditional notch in the rear, so we stuck with that and did your regular bridge. It's got the airbags and everything mounted above the axle. Front has the control arms with custom cupped lowers and tubular uppers. As you can see, the truck's got suicide doors, suicide hood. Wanted to go with a mini truck theme on a full size truck. Always wanted to build a mini truck. Never got to do that with the hard body that I had, being that it was wrecked back in the late 90s. Kind of got out of that scene. And guess what? Fast and the Furious hit. So no more trucks for me. Ended up buying an import, bought an Nissan Maxima, rode that around for a couple years, did all kinds of stuff to that, and really missed it. So I picked up an 89 Chevy S10, went lowrider with that truck for a little while, but didn't really like it. Kind of got rid of that truck and really wanted to get a C10, so here we are. So in the engine bay, it's got a 350 small block. A couple winters ago, wanted to freshen it all up. We pulled the engine out, freshened all the paint up, cleaned everything up, put on new headers, new air cleaner and everything. Did some work to the firewall, got rid of the heater box, shaved the firewall, got rid of the factory inner fenders, went with a set of custom sheet metal fenders that I built, put those in. And as far as the hood and stuff goes, wanted to go custom with that. Always liked the suicide hoods that everybody did back in the late 80s, early 90s. So me and some of the club members got together and built these hinges that are custom, pipe hinges and everything, so that the hood could open up the way you see there. On the inner fenders, got the passenger side fender dedicated to my boys. I call them Buddy and Bubba, so I hand painted that all myself on that side with their names on it. On the driver's side, I put that one together for my wife and I. So you'll see El Padrino and Mamita on that one, and you'll see a picture of the truck dragging through on the fender. So we were bullshitting one night. We was messing around and somebody asked what the truck's name was. I never really had a name for it. My nickname's Alvarez, El Padrino. Thought about calling the truck El Padrino. Didn't really care for that too much. And one guy in the club, Marty's like, you ought to call it Cuban Pete. Thought that was kind of funny. I am Cuban. Really like the movies. Mask. Jim Carrey sang that song Cuban Pete in the movie, so it's kind of cool, so I just stuck with that. You can see on the hood cowl on the side, you'll see Cuban Pete. I hand painted that on there one day by myself, so that's where that came from. So the wheels are Riddler 645. Funny how those wheels came about. Not funny, almost a tragic story. Going to a car show called Creatures of the Night one time up in York, PA. We were heading up there and had a set of chrome 20s on there that had 2-inch adapters. They were 6-lug wheels, truck's 5-lug. So with the adapters on there, hit a couple potholes heading up to Creatures of the Night. With that said, 3 of the heads on the bolts snapped off and almost lost a wheel. Me and my wife are driving up to the show, feel something in the floor, and she's like, Chris, your wheel is making some kind of noise. I'm like, all right, it's fine. She peeks out the window and she sees the wheel and it's going like this. So we had to pull off on the side of the road. Almost lost that wheel. Luckily I didn't. Got off in time. All the club members stuck by me the whole time, helped me repair the wheel. Had a friend of another friend that had a spare wheel, brought me up a wheel to put on the truck so we can make it to the show still. About 2 hours later, we finally got the wheel on and we were headed back up to the show and got to Creatures. Oh yeah, so the bags and everything, I got 25 and 2600 pound. I got Firestone in the rear and Air Max bags in the front. As far as the tank goes, I have a 5 gallon air tank in the bed. Two 444 Vi-Air compressors in the rear. The valves are all SMC. I got 2 half-inch fill valves for the front, 3/8 fill valves for the rear, and all the dumps are 3/8 SMCs. I wanted to have something different, so I made a little stand for the compressors and the air tank, and then got a Thor Brothers aluminum manifold so that all the valves can mount together and all be one single unit, and they all blend together. It all looks really good in the back. Yeah, so that was my favorite color combination. It was either the blue and white or the orange and white that they had back then. Was looking around on Craigslist, been wanting the truck for a while, been looking around, and as soon as I flipped to that truck, I was like, that is the one. We were walking around Walmart one night, and I messaged a guy, like, it was like 11 o'clock, it was back when Walmart was 24 hours. Me and the wife were walking around, and I would not shut up about the truck. Kept talking about it, kept flicking back and forth to the pictures of it and everything, and hoping the guy would message me back, and the next morning, got a message from the guy telling me if I wanted to come check it out. Went and checked it out the following weekend and took it home that day. It's the original blue and white paint. As far as I know, there is some greenish gold looking color underneath some of the paint, so it may have been another color, but that is original paint. As far as the guy told me, that's roughly 20 some years old at least. Had to do a little bit more of the paint on the door once I do some more this winter, just to blend the blue and the white back in. But really enjoy the patina look, and a lot of people do like it, and a lot of people do hate it. The guy told me the engine only had around 31,000 miles. It has a GMC crate motor that was installed in it. Not sure of the date or anything. He didn't have the receipts or anything, but he did tell me it had about 31,000 miles on it. The odometer, I believe, is 111,000, because I don't think they had the 100,000 number on there, but it says 11,800 and something like that on it.
Awesome.
So I would say sometime in 93, 94, I believe it was my freshman year of high school, was at a Sheetz one day and was looking at the magazines that they had there as I was waiting to check out. And I came across a 4x4 and off-road magazine, had a nice big lifted truck on it, which was kind of cool. But there was a mini trucking magazine that was like halfway underneath that magazine. And I was like, what the hell is that? I'd seen them around, but didn't really know much about the mini truck scene or anything or how big it actually was. Grabbed that magazine, and that pretty much started it for me there. First truck that I decided I was going to try to build was a 97. My parents bought me a 1988 Nissan Hardbody Extended Cab, completely bone stock. Like I said, they got it for my graduation. Just saved up a bunch of money. Got a set of American Racing Hammer wheels for it in a 15-inch. This was pretty much before Hagerstown saw all the 20s and everything that we were getting big. So 15s were a cool wheel back then, nice chrome wheel. Got the truck lowered. It was just static dropped. Did a bunch of body work. Some of the rust was coming through on the fenders and everything. So the truck was red when I bought it and became primer gray. A lot of people ran around like that and did the whole under construction thing when they would go to car shows. Had big plans for the truck. Had to pick my sister up from school one day back in 98. Had to go pick my sister up from school, and on the way to picking her up, I got into an accident in the truck. Hit a car that was going reverse in my lane. The lady overshot her driveway. Truck ended up getting totaled, pushed the motor about 2 inches toward the passenger side, and the front was completely crushed. Never got to rebuilding the truck like I wanted to do. It sat behind my parents' house, I think, until like 2005, 2006. So it sat there for almost 10 years. Yeah. Thought I was going to rebuild it. Pulled a bunch of stuff off the truck. Thought I was going to get another hard body in 98. And then drove around a couple different cars here and there. Didn't really have anything that I wanted to fix up. Had an Astro van that had a set of 17-inch Eagle alloys on it. Thought I was going to do a bunch of stuff to that. It wasn't really my thing. Like I said, a couple years just drove around and whatever. And in 99, I picked up the Nissan Maxima. It was a 92 four-door, complete stock, and didn't know how I really wanted to go. It was just a good commuter car. I was driving over an hour to work every day, so it was a good commuter car. Then 2000 hit, and Fast and the Furious came out. And it was all downhill from there. Car got the full bright paint, had a 98 Lamborghini orange paint job with gold pearl, 17-inch ICW racing wheels, had a custom front bumper molded from a 2000 Suzuki Aereo that was being thrown away at the job that I had. So I took it out of the dumpster, had it completely molded on, had all the door moldings taken off, had the whole side shaved, shaved the trunk lid, had a Wings West wing on it. Nice stereo, 215s in the trunk. Cut the springs in that, had it lowered a little bit. Drove that around for 2 or 3 years. Didn't really like it after so long. It just kind of got boring to me. Really wanted to get back into the mini truck scene. So I bought a 1989 Chevy S10. The Chevy S10 kind of went in a different direction because I thought I wanted to build a lowrider. Ended up with a set of 14-inch Luxor wire wheels. Rode around with them for a couple years. Put drop spindles, had it lowered. Shaved the whole rear end, Cadillac taillights. Did this cool spider web license plate frame that I welded together when I was doing the Cadillac taillights and everything. Had that for a while, started having some problems with it, so the truck sat for a little while. Thought I was going to get into four-wheel drives, went out and bought an 89 Jeep Wrangler, big tires and everything. Definitely not my cup of tea. That Jeep was gone in a matter of months. Had a family, bought a house. And everything went on hold from 2005-ish, as far as the custom car scene goes, up until about 2018. We would go to car shows here and there just to see the vehicles and stuff, but never really had anything that I wanted to fix up. Definitely always wanted to get a C10, always thought they were cool. And that's when Cuban Pete was built. Just wanted to give a shout out to some of the guys in the car club. I bought the truck, like I said, in 2018. I bought it in April. Living in an apartment, didn't really have anywhere to keep the truck. My buddy Kyle Collins, want to give a huge shout out to him. He told me that if I got the truck that I could keep it at his garage, build the truck there, do anything that I want at his garage. So I want to give a huge shout out to him, because if it wasn't for him and letting me keep the truck there, not sure how far along the truck would be. The first year I really wanted to get the truck done and get it out and hit shows with it. So I bought the truck in 2018, did all the regular maintenance stuff to the truck, got the truck drivable, got it reliable, checked everything out. November 1st, the truck went into the garage and didn't come out again until the end of March for the next show season. That was when all the air ride and everything was done. So a huge shout out to Kyle and them and anybody from the club that came out and helped me out with the truck in the beginning. If it wasn't for all you guys in the Art of Illusions, I don't know that the truck would have got done. You all kept me motivated, kept me going. So I really appreciate everything you guys have done and everybody that's come along the way that I've met through everything in the truck. My wife, my boys, they've always been there and had my back the entire time. They're my biggest supporters. So the truck is definitely dedicated to them, as you can see by the inner fenders and everything. If it wasn't for them, just like everybody, truck wouldn't be what it is today. We'll be right back. Did some custom pinstriping in the hood or in the engine bay, blooper one.
Huh?
So you don't know the story, bro.
Well, now I do. And so will the
That's
world.
Right, and the world shall know.
I'm a fucking idiot. I'm sitting here looking at it, and I could see you. So I'm turning my phone instead of this, thinking it's going to get you out of the fucking video. I'm like, why is it working?
I didn't mean to hit that button.